Why is there so much confusion on the dogma of the Catholic Church, especially on perpetual virginity? What does it mean? It simply means that Our Lady was a virgin before and after the birth of Jesus Christ. Then many a times there are people who ask who are the brothers and sisters of Jesus, as it is mentioned in the scripture. Let us first understand in which context it was written. In Hebrew language, for brothers and sisters are mentioned for all the cousins in the family. There is no separate word for cousin brother or cousin sisters. What impacts me the most is if Jesus had his very own brother or sister, would he give his mother to John the Apostle? I think we have to reflect on this point, where at the cross he gives us his mother. Mary was a shadow of Jesus from birth to death, honoring her son. And a shadow never eclipses the reality. Mother Mary was the only anointed person who from the cross took up all the disciples to the upper room. She comforted them, she prayed with them, and it was here that the church was born.
Let's have a brief look at the history. So far today, in 2020, we have so many churches of different denominations. Let's go back, say around 2020 years back. We had Mary with the 12 disciples in the upper room, and the church was born on the day of Pentecost. What happened 3 years before that? We had Jesus with the 12 disciples. 30 years before that, we had Jesus with Mother Mary. And yes, we all know from where did it come? From Angel Gabriel to Mother Mary, the announcement was given that you shall bear a son who will be called Jesus. So my friends, if you see, the whole church is hanging on the yes of Mother Mary, where she says, I am the handmaid of the Lord.
Whenever you turn towards Our Lady, you will definitely hear a voice saying, do whatever he tells you. Do you know that Mary is called as a new Ark of the Covenant? Let's see what was kept in the Ark of the Covenant. They were the Ten Commandments, manna, and the buttered Aaron staff. Today, what does it simplify? It signifies the staff, which is the priesthood, and that refers to Jesus, who is the high priest. The manna, which is Eucharist. The Ten Commandments, the Word, and as St. John the Gospel says, the Word becomes flesh in Mary's womb. Now, let's see to some scriptural references. In Luke 1:39, we know that Mary rushes to Judea to meet Elizabeth. And in 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 16, King David comes to Judah taking the Ark of the Covenant. The second is the greetings given by Elizabeth is seen in 2 Samuel 6:9, where King David says, how can the Ark of the Covenant be kept in my home? And the third, where we know baby John leapt with joy in the womb of Elizabeth. We see this reference in 2 Samuel 6:5, where King David dances with joy in front of the Ark of the Covenant. Zion is said to be a symbol of Mother Mary. We read in Isaiah chapter 66 verse 7, before she was in labor, she gave birth. Before a pain came upon her, she delivered a son. We know by Bible scholars where Jesus was born even without any labor pain. Let's look at verse 8. Yet, as soon as Zion was in labor, she delivered her children. Yes, Mother Mary was in deep labor pains at the foot of the cross where she gave birth to her children. Mother Mary is our mediatrix. As she formed Jesus in her body, so she forms Jesus in our souls. And how does she do that? She was the first and the perfect disciple of her son for 33 years, much more than the apostles. As you see, they were with Jesus for just 3 years. She is the living tabernacle of the Lord of heaven and earth. There were so many saints in the history of the Catholic Church who have given witness to the divine protection of Our Lady. You can definitely check out our video on the secret to sainthood. The link would be given in the description box. Saint Padre Pio says, "Mary is the whole reason of my hope." He had these words written on the door of his cell. Friends, let's not miss this most important privilege of honoring our mother. Don't forget to recite your daily rosary, the devotion on first Saturday to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. The Memorare gives us a lot of graces. Even the simple three Hail Mary devotion brings us near and near to Jesus. God bless you all.